transport of gases, how the oxygen is carried out from the lungs to the tissues and the carbon dioxide from the tissues to the lung. About 97% of the oxygen is carried out through RBC in the form of oxyhemoglobin and remaining 3% of the oxygen is carried out in the dissolved state through plasma. And coming to the carbon dioxide, about 70% of carbon dioxide is carried out in the form of bicarbonates. And 20 to 25% through RBC. In the form of carbamino hemoglobin. So 70% of the carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lung in the form of bicarbonates, and 20 to 25% of the carbon dioxide through the RBC in the form of carbamino hemoglobin, and about 7% of the carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lung in the form of dissolved state in the plasma. Okay, transport of gases. How the oxygen is carried out from the lungs to the tissues and the carbon dioxide from the tissues to the lung. About 97% of the oxygen is transported through RBC from lungs to the tissues in the form of oxyhemoglobin. And remaining 3% of the oxygen is carried out in the dissolved state through plasma. And when we see carbon dioxide, 70% of the carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lung in the form of bicarbonates, and 20 to 25% of the carbon dioxide through RBC in the form of carbamino hemoglobin, and the remaining 7% of the carbon dioxide through dissolved state in the plasma. Okay, now let's clearly understand how the oxygen is transported from the lungs to the tissues. So let us now see how the oxygen is transported from the lungs to the tissues in detail. So the hemoglobin is a red colored iron containing pigment which can bind with the oxygen reversibly. So think that hemoglobin is a four-seated vehicle. So in the four seats, four oxygen molecules can sit. So about four oxygen molecules are carried from the lungs to the tissues by one hemoglobin molecule. So about four oxygen molecules can be carried out by one hemoglobin okay now this binding of oxygen with the hemoglobin is mainly dependent on the partial pressure of oxygen and this is also affected by the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, temperature and H plus ions. So the main factor responsible for the binding of the oxygen with the hemoglobin is the partial pressure of oxygen and partial pressure of carbon dioxide, temperature and the concentration of H plus ions can also alter the binding of the oxygen with the hemoglobin, but to a little extent. So let us now see the dissociation curve of oxygen. So the oxygen dissociation curve. These are the values of partial pressure of oxygen. And here, this is the percentage saturation of hemoglobin with O2. Okay, when we plot a graph between percent of saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen and the partial pressure of oxygen, we will get a sigmoid shaped curve. So this is the sigmoid shaped curve we will get when we plot a graph between the partial pressure of oxygen and the percentage saturation of the hemoglobin with oxygen. Let us now try to understand what is actually the dissociation curve of oxygen. See, when the partial pressure of oxygen is at 100, when the partial pressure of oxygen is 100, this will be in the mmHg. So when the partial pressure of oxygen is 100 mmHg, the percentage of saturation is 100%. So when the partial pressure of oxygen is 100 mmHg, the percentage of saturation is 100%. And when it reaches to the it is about 95%. So the partial pressure of the oxygen is the main factor which determines the percentage saturation of the hemoglobin with oxygen. That is binding of the oxygen with the hemoglobin. Understood clearly? Let me repeat this. The partial pressure of oxygen, when it is 100 mmHg, the percentage saturation of the hemoglobin with oxygen, that is the binding of the oxygen with the hemoglobin, is 100%. When it reaches 80 mmHg, that is decrease in the partial pressure of oxygen, the binding of oxygen with hemoglobin is only 95%. As it when it is decreases to the 50%, now approximately it will be about 75%. So as the partial pressure of the oxygen decreases, the percentage saturation of the hemoglobin with oxygen decreases. That is binding of the oxygen with hemoglobin. Percentage saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen means the binding of oxygen with the hemoglobin. Okay, this is dissociation curve of oxygen. This is in the shape of sigmoid. So the dissociation curve is in the shape of sigmoid. And the other factors which can interfere with the binding of oxygen with hemoglobin are partial pressure of carbon dioxide, temperature, and the concentration of H+ ions. So these can interfere with the binding of the oxygen with hemoglobin. And now let us see the favorable conditions for the binding of oxygen with hemoglobin. We have two sites, that is at alveoli and at tissue. So let us compare the partial pressure of oxygen, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide, and the temperature and the H+ ions concentration. So at the alveolar level, the partial pressure of oxygen is high, and at the tissue level, partial pressure of oxygen is low. And partial pressure of carbon dioxide at the alveolar level is low, temperature is low, and H+ ions is also low. Here, at the level of tissues, partial pressure of carbon dioxide, temperature, and the concentration of H+ ions is more. So, as we have already discussed, the dissociation curve of oxygen . So when the partial pressure of oxygen is high, the binding of oxygen with the hemoglobin is more. So at the highest level of partial pressure of oxygen, the binding of oxygen with hemoglobin is more. So as partial pressure of oxygen is more at the alveolar level, the binding of oxygen with the hemoglobin is more in the alveolar level. So at the tissue level, partial pressure of oxygen is less. Hence, here the oxygen hemoglobin binding is not that easy. So here the oxygen will leave hemoglobin. Okay, so carbon dioxide, temperature, and H+ ions concentration will favor the formation of oxyhemoglobin here, that is binding of oxygen with hemoglobin, and here at the tissue level, it favors the dissociation of oxygen with the hemoglobin. So this is about transportation of the oxygen, and it is all about 97% of the oxygen is transported in the form of oxyhemoglobin, and the remaining 3% of oxygen in the dissolved state through plasma. Okay, and for every 100 ml of the blood, about 5 ml of oxygen is delivered to the tissue. So for every 100 ml of the blood, 5 ml of the oxygen is delivered to the tissue. Clear? So this is about the transport of oxygen from lungs to the tissue. Now, transport of carbon dioxide from the tissue to the lungs. Okay, now transport of carbon dioxide. Transport of CO2. Okay, carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lungs in three forms. Number one, as the dissolved state in the plasma. It is about 7%. Okay, and the second type. After binding with the hemoglobin, it is carbamino hemoglobin. So the second type is carbamino hemoglobin, and the percentage is 20 to 25%. So the 20 to 25% of the carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lungs in the form of carbamino hemoglobin. And the last type, that is in the form of bicarbonates. So about 70%, about 70% of the carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lungs in the form of bicarbonates. Okay. So about 7% through dissolved state in plasma, 20 to 25% as carbamino hemoglobin, and 70% as bicarbonates. Okay. Now let us see how the carbamino hemoglobin is formed and transported from the tissues to the lungs. Okay, now let us see how the carbamino hemoglobin is formed and transported from the tissue to the lungs. See, at tissue level and at the alveolar level. So mainly the carbamino hemoglobin formation is based on the partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Partial pressure of carbon dioxide. So at the tissue level, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is more, and at the alveoli level, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is less. And carbamino hemoglobin is favored at the level of tissue, as the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is more. The partial pressure of carbon dioxide favors the formation of carbamino hemoglobin, and as the level of partial pressure of carbon dioxide is less at the level of alveoli, carbon dioxide from the hemoglobin dissociates. So about 20 to 25% of the carbon dioxide is transported in the form of carbamino hemoglobin through blood. Okay, then bicarbonates. About 70% of the carbon dioxide is transported from the tissues to the lungs in the form of bicarbonates. Let us see how we daily see the advertisement of Boost. Boost is the secret of those sportsman's energy. So here, Boost-like structure carbonic anhydrase. You must remember this. Carbonic anhydrase. It is the boost in the formation of bicarbonates. See, carbon dioxide combining with water forms the H2CO3 in the reversible form, and then H2CO3 dissociates into HCO3- and H+ ion. So that is why when the carbon dioxide is more, automatically H+ ions will also more. Now, if the carbonic anhydrase enzyme is not present, this process of formation of bicarbonates, is so slow. But when the carbonic anhydrase enzyme acts on this reaction, it is very faster. So the carbonic anhydrase enzyme fastens the reaction to forward and also backward. So the action of carbonic anhydrase will make the reaction faster. And then see, at the tissue level, the carbonic anhydrase enzyme will favor this in the forward direction. And at the alveolar level, it favors in the backward direction. That is, it again forms the carbon dioxide and H2O. So carbon dioxide, which is released at the alveoli, will be released out into the atmosphere. For every 100 ml of blood, about 4 ml of CO2 is transported. So for every 100 ml of blood, 4 ml of carbon dioxide is transported from tissues to the lungs. Thank you.